I tell this story many times, and I don't mind repeating it again. I wanted my boy to become very creative. I said, how do you do that? I said, I don't know. So I read the lives of many famous people. What made them creative? I found out what those mechanisms were. And so the way it was applied, I talked to my son about animals in the zoo. And he said to me, Daddy, can we go to the zoo to see these animals? I said, yes. He said with great anxiety, when? I said, next month. Next month? He didn't like that at all, but I wanted to build a hunger in him. And when Saturday approached a month later, he says, we're going to the zoo tomorrow, aren't we? I said, yes, we are. And I noticed in doing that, delaying it, he really studied every animal. If I took him right to the zoo, he probably hoped the monkeys would jump around. So kids throw spitballs at the monkeys to get them to jump around. And so I found that most kids are more than fulfilled. They're given rewards, toys, all kinds of things, and they got a closet full of toys, and the parents wonder why they have no incentive. Because they haven't been rewarded for what they do. They've been rewarded, period, because Daddy didn't have all those toys when he was young. So they buy the kid all the stuff they never had, and they wonder why their kid behaves like a blob. So when I took my kid to the zoo, I said, when he was looking at all the animals, when he seemed to have terrific drive towards studying the animals, I said, I have a business appointment in town. I had no such appointment, but I took him away from that when he was high. And I put drawing paper in his bedroom and clay. I knew what would happen. When he came back, he saw all that stuff. He started to make animals out of the clay. He made giraffes and dinosaurs. They weren't very good. So I said to him, outside and play. He said, but I like being alone making things. I said, outside and play with the other kids. Since he learned to like being by himself, he didn't depend on the other kids for reward, or that'll never fly, or I can run faster than you. All he met was competitive behavior. Not all kids, but most kids. That was not good. But at home, when he was making all the animals and enjoying it with a great big grin on his face, when I set out and play, I disrupted that creativity, which he couldn't wait to get back to. He became very good at illustrating and making things. My little girl, when she was 3 years old, I wanted her to think about the environment. So I put a wrench on, and not the wrong way. And it kept slipping off.